Good morning, dear students. How are you all? I hope you all are well. Welcome back to our lesson that is matter around us pure. See, in this topic, various things we have seen, types of mixtures we have seen, types of solutions we have seen. Then we were looking for our next topic, that is separating techniques for such kind of mixtures. Okay, so various kinds of separating techniques are present. Out of this, three separating techniques we have already seen. Now we will go for the next separating technique, that is sublimation method. Actually, this method I am going to revise, because sublimation technique I have showed you in my first lesson, that is matter around us, as well as I have shown you in the practical also. Means I have taken you all to the chemistry lab and I have shown you this method. But once again, as this is the part from the is matter around us lesson, I have to repeat and I have to explain it properly in detail. So first of all, I would like to clear the concept of the sublimation. What is mean by sublimation, students? Can you give me the definition of the sublimation, or can you give some examples which are examples of the sublimatory substances? So the definition for the sublimation process is the process of change of substance from solid state to gaseous state without undergoing into liquid state and vice versa is called sublimation. It's called sublimation process. Means substance, solid substance, which will directly undergo into the gaseous state. Gaseous state. Okay? And from gaseous state, it will directly turn into solid state. Means it will not undergo. Means any substance we will take. There are examples of the sublimatory substance, that is camphor, naphthalene ball, camphor which we use in our puja, kapur we say in Marathi, naphthalene balls which we keep into the layers of our cloth to protect it from the insects. Okay, so that is camphor, and naphthalene ball is a sublimatory substance, as well as in chemistry laboratory there is one we use, that is ammonium chloride, and the formula for it is NH4Cl. This is ammonium chloride, which is also undergo the process of sublimation. Means these substances are in the solid state, but directly these substances are going into the gaseous state. These are not undergoing or not following the liquid state. Mainly what happens, solid, liquid and the gas. But here it doesn't happen. Solid to direct gaseous state. Okay, and from gaseous state they return back into the solid state. They do not undergo the liquid state, and that is called as a sublimation process. So here, why this technique we use when the two substances or the two salts are mixed together? Suppose see NH4Cl, you have not seen NH4Cl, but NH4Cl is also in a crystalline form. It looks like our common salt which we use in our daily food to enhance the taste of the food. That is our common salt, NaCl that is called. So this is also one kind of salt. So this salt and common salt looks very similar. Means we cannot identify if it is mixed together, right? And if we want our salt back, or we want to purify the ammonium chloride, then we can utilize the sublimation technique. How can we utilize? See, here is one example in front of me. I will explain you how can we utilize this technique to separate the pure substance from the impure one, or how can we separate the two substances which are mixed together by mistake. Understood? So this technology is mostly used into the laboratory and into the huge factories and industries, companies this technology is used. Okay, so here I would like to explain you through this example. See here, students, you can see there is one tripod stand. you are quite acquainted with it. I have already shown you this tripod stand into the chemistry laboratory. Or last, in some videos also I have given you the acquisition of this tripod stand. So there is one tripod stand. Below tripod stand, there is Bunsen burner. Above it, there is China dish. And in that China dish, the sample is kept. Now, what is meant by sample? The substances, two substances which are mixed together. Here I have taken the sample of NH4Cl and NaCl. NH4Cl plus NaCl. NH4Cl undergoes the process of sublimation. So NaCl and NH4Cl, which look quite similar, I have mixed them together and I have kept it on the China dish. Okay. After it, what I have done? I have kept one inverted funnel over it. Inverted funnel. Okay, funnel we are knowing that we have kept inverted. Okay, inverted funnel we have kept, and to pack that funnel, the hole, the stem of the funnel, above the stem of the funnel, you can see there is small hole. Okay, which we use in the filtration technique. So this small hole is required to pass the substance out. But here we don't have to pass, right? So what we will do? We will use one cotton plug over it. Okay, and we will seal this with the cotton plug. Okay, and here Bunsen burner is also there. Okay, now I have kept my sample over there and I have tried, I have started providing heat for the liquid. As I started providing heat for the liquid, immediately what will happen, the NH4Cl, which undergo the process of sublimation, will try to stick to the stem and the part, other part of the inverted funnel. Okay, means this fumes or this fume-like structure, whatever it would come, okay, or this in the vapor form, whatever it will come, that is NH4Cl, will try to come and will not allow to go out from the inverted funnel, out of the stem of the funnel. It will not go because we have plugged it with the cotton plug. We have enclosed it with the cotton plug. And so that what would happen? The fumes will get accumulated at the walls of the funnel as well as into the stem of the funnel. Okay. And what will remain into the sample, or what will remain into the China dish wherever we have kept our sample? Yes, you are absolutely right. You will get NaCl or sodium chloride will get remain at the base, and NH4Cl whatever, because it will go undergo into the gaseous state. So the vapors of this NH4Cl will get accumulated at the walls of the funnel and into the stem. Okay, and easily, this is the easiest method to separate the substances which undergo the process of the sublimation. Okay, and this is a homogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture means because both are into the crystalline state, so we are unable to recognize them. And for that sake, we are following this technique, and that technique is called as a sublimation. In tomorrow's lecture, I will explain you another technique of the separation. Thank you.